Now, the camp of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno refutes claims. His rhetoric against Vice President Lenny Robredo is backfiring. Moreno's campaign manager, Lito Banayo, tells critics to just wait for the results of the elections. He also hit the Robredo camp for saying it's their supporters who had called on Moreno to withdraw.
Ang lagi nila excuse, eh. Hindi naman si Lenny ang nagsasabi kundi yung supporters niya. Wow! A leader should know how to control her supporters. Parang hinuhubaran sila ng mga supporters, no? Of course, the supporters are always free to change their minds, no? But that there is an effort. There is a very clear effort, no? On the part of the camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo, no? To do precisely that.
As for Vice President Lenny Robredo, she says she will not entertain the attacks coming from Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. She says a lot is at stake in the upcoming May elections, and it should not be a fight between presidential candidates.
Hindi ko siya papatulan dahil hindi naman ito simpleng laban lang namin dalawa. Yung laban ito ng bayan natin, may mas malaking laban na kailangan nating panalunin. Gaya ng sinabi ko kanina, extraordinary ang eleksyon na to. Hindi lang ito contest ng mga kandidato, pero ito yung magde-determine kung anong klaseng pamamahala at politika yung mananaig sa bayan natin in the next 6 years. Na yun yung pinapakipaglaban natin ngayon. And hinihikayat natin yung lahat. Nasamahan tayo sa laban na to. Hindi na tayo mag-suspend ng time na makipag-away sa ibang kandidato kasi yung laban na to is more than all of us combined.
An economist believes the country needs a Lenny Robredo presidency to steer economic recovery through the COVID-19 pandemic. In a statement, Philippine Central Bank Deputy Governor Diwa Ginigindo cited the pandemic response efforts launched by the Vice President's office despite having little budget. He added, Robredo is unlike her rival, former Senator Bongbong Marcos, who has tax and corruption issues hanging over his head. Ginigindo is among the more than 100 top economists who have endorsed Robredo's presidential bid. A gathering of presidential aspirants is bound to turn into a fiasco. That's according to Senator Coco Pimentel, chairman of the PDP Laban Party's Pacquiao wing. He adds, it seemed like presidential bet Manny Pacquiao never really intended to attend because the press con did not have a clear agenda.
A gathering of presidential candidates, all in many of them in one press conference, has the potential of really exploding and turning into a fiasco because they are all presidential candidates and they would want the spotlight to be focused on himself or herself, diba? So that's not really a brilliant idea or even a good idea unless they wrote down the agreement, the agenda, and they signed on the agreement.
And we're just over 2 weeks before the elections. Pimentel says Pacquiao's presidential campaign is on the right track.
As I compared our campaign, I compared it to an airplane taking off. So. I think we are now reaching our cruising altitude. That is the highest point in the flight. Oh, we will finish strong. Senator Manny Pacquiao is now going to, or maybe right now, is already in Bohol and Cebu. So Visayas and Mindanao would be the last leg of the campaign.
The Commission on Elections investigates the firing of gunshots during a campaign event of presidential aspirant Leody de Guzman in Bukidnon. Commissioner Amy Ferolino, the vice chairman of the Committee on the Ban on Firearms and Security Concerns, is leading the probe. On Tuesday, de Guzman and Senate Bets Roy Cabonegro and David DeAngelo were discussing land-grabbing issues with a group of indigenous people when the shooting happened. 5 people were hurt in that incident. The COMELEC says they're seeing higher turnout among Filipino voters abroad. Commissioner Marlon Casquejo says they've already hit their target just about 2 weeks into the voting period. Data from COMELEC showed there are about 1.7 million Filipinos living abroad who are registered in the 2022 polls.
For this early time of period of voting, we have already reached our target, which is more than 30%. So we're expecting a higher voting turnout for our overseas voting. You know, in the previous elections, we only have about 20% or even less than 20% voting turnout. So we introduced some scheme like the Vote Anywhere's concept and also the field registration, field voting.
Casquejo also says a photo of a pre-shaded ballot making the rounds online is fake, but he admits they have yet to trace its source.
It's not a ballot that being distributed by our posts. Maybe it was edited ballot or whatsoever. Because number two, we cannot trace it also. We're trying to contact the person through the console wherever it was posted.
Operations at the Philippine Consulate in New York suspended after almost half of its personnel either contracted COVID or were exposed to it. According to Consul General El Mercato, there is an ongoing surge in New York. He thinks the lifting of the mask mandate on public transport may have contributed to the uptick in infections. But he assures Filipinos the overseas voting process will continue despite their lack of manpower.
Patuloy pa rin yung trabaho natin. In fact, nung dumating yung balota nung Monday, nakapaglabas na kami ng ilan. As of this evening, we already have sent out almost 70%. So confident naman po kami na mapapadala namin lahat ng balota to our kababayan here in the United States Northeast before the end of the week. Kahit may na-COVID ho sa amin, yung natitira sa amin, nandito pa rin, nandito sa konsulado ngayon, we're trying to do everything we can para makuha ng ating mga kababayan yung kanilang mga balota.